Good morning. My son took my job, so I haven't had a chance to do this for a while. So, really, really good to see you all, and we are going to worship God together this morning. We're going to thank Him for the things that He's done, and we're going to learn from Him. A couple of quick announcements before we get into that. Next week, after church, there's going to be a brainstorming session, and it's going to be a lunch provided. If you were there last week, you know that lunch is worth coming just for that. Thanks, Pat. But we want to talk. The brainstorming session is for people who are involved in the worship ministry or who want to be involved in the worship ministry, and there's a lot going on in that booth back there. There's a lot of training that needs to go in to before people are confident, and I often forget step 17 of how to get ready for church. So it's, it would be good to have a team working on the technology part. There's a bunch of room for instruments up here, and so if you're working on instruments or you know someone who is and who wants to make a joyful noise with us, there's room for you here. If you want to come and help me sing, help Aiden sing. If you want to try your hand at being a worship leader, come on after church on Sunday, stay for lunch and talk. And we're also going to be talking about the prayer ministry. So if you have a vision for prayer for our church, that's coming. Now, this Sunday, you may have heard that it's a special Sunday for one of our saints, and actually a couple of them. So you are going to definitely want to come downstairs after the service and celebrate together. And we'll sing a song down there and blow out some candles. So just so you know what's coming, but we'll wait to do it until then. We're going to be talking about prayer this morning, talking with God, hearing from God. So let's start by practicing. Let's do that. Let's all bow our heads and invite God into this service, which is, dear God, thank you that you are already here. You've been waiting for us to come and meet with you. Thank you that you have loved us and rescued us. Thank you for all the things that you've done and the way that you have prepared the way for us this morning. And I pray that this morning we would be good soil so that when you plant seeds, it will produce good fruit. Thank you, Lord, for every part of the service and every person that's here. And I pray that you would bless us. And we ask this just because you love us, not because of anything that we've done. Thank you so much for your grace your forgiveness and your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, I'm going to ask everyone who feels healthy to stand up. If you're healthy enough to stand and sing, it helps you. It helps you sing, so it helps me sing. So there's people singing back. Oh, now guess what I did? I left my book behind. I don't trust my memory that much. So, give us clean hands and start to we bow our hearts.
We bow our hearts, we bend our knees. O Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. O Lord, we cast down our idols. Give us clean hands, give us pure hearts.
Creation groaning,
it is.
Is
I'm
together and sing the doxology.
The same key.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly roles. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
All right. We're done. You can have a seat. We're going to do a bunch of different things today because we're going to talk about prayer. And today is Mrs. Schultz's birthday. We're probably going to sing happy birthday a bunch of times today. But, and by the way, it's my birthday too. Before we go away, in Sunday school, did you do that? Happy birthday.
Yes.
Some of you know that? It's a different version of happy birthday. So you can learn it. So we're going to sing it to Mrs. Schultz. I don't know if I remember.
Happy birthday.
Sunday where we had the pews in a circle and people shared testimony. But I don't know if you've had an opportunity to hear Mrs. Schultz's story. And so she's going to share that. She's going to share some scripture and some poems, or at least one poem here. And the poem, one of the poems that she's going to share, probably, we'll see how much energy she's got. I'm going to get a chair for her here. And if you haven't ever heard it before, she has like hundreds of poems memorized, many of them scripture verses from over the years. And she can recite them to this day, so there's no excuse for any of you saying, I'm too old to memorize. She memorizes and she learns things and she's got them in her head still at 99. So, Mrs. Schultz, I'm going to put a chair up here, but would you come and share now?
Farming wasn't
very different with horses and neighbors helping one another. Mother played the organ and she told me I went to church when I was only 2 weeks old because she was playing. Then that was at the old Anglican church, and that is where I was christened as well. Then Mother went playing for the United Church, and she played there for over 50 years. I grew up meaning and going to church every Sunday. Farming was a day of hard work. And when I went to school, I walked 2.5 miles to the old brick school here in Honolulu. And then a lady moved to Honolulu who was a very fine Christian lady, and she started a girls' group. CGIT, Canadian Girls in Training, under the leadership of Jesus. It is my purpose to cherish health, see truth, know God, and serve others, and thus, with His help, become the girl that God would have me be. And then she also taught me poetry and my narration. And that's where I started with the poems. And let me see. Yeah. And that spring, and that was in 1934, my little brother got diphtheria and passed away. And then I was quarantined from school, so I had to stay home and help my dad with all the chores, cows to milk, pigs to feed, chickens to feed, and I was to do the housework, and to make bread was one of my hardest things because I couldn't keep that yeast warm, set it at night. But it didn't keep warm. If only I would have thought to take it to bed, it would have kept warm. But anyway, we had to eat the bread as it was. Anyway, that was 6 weeks from the time my brother passed away to when Rita was born, and that was my little sister. We were very happy to have her. But while I was quarantined, I had to do everything. And then my little sister was born the 1st of July. I soon quit school and went to work housekeeping for $10 a month. And I was glad I was able to buy winter clothes for $10. everything was about $2 a piece. There. And then when I went to work, I met Walter, and we were married the 10th of October, 1940. And as my, there was a quarter for sale right next to my parents, so Walter dealt with the people and we got that. Then we were able to work, Walter was able to work with my parents, and they did the farming together. And as Walter had worked at dairies, and he knew people that had little calves, so he would go and buy these little calves, and pretty soon we had a dairy going. But Walter also spent his winter in a bush getting out the logs on our own land, and he took them to the neighbors where they were made into lumber, and it was, he built two big barns for the cattle. He had one barn held 22, and the other barn held the pigs. And then there was a chicken house, and the house that we lived in on the farm was also built with that lumber. And he got these calves from the different people that had dairies, and that's the way we started. And we had the three children, and they all helped us on the farm. We sold a can of cream in the peak of time, a can of cream a day. We had that average for 4 years, the highest cream production. That was in the summertime. And the children helped us milk the cows. And then in the year of 1959, the Baptist Church right here had revival meetings with Reverend Pfeiffer. And we went to the service, and Walter had accepted the Lord, and I went up with him and rededicated his mind. But meanwhile, the young people had gone to the Free Church where Bob Stevens was the minister. And there, Donald accepted the Lord as his Savior. Now I say I can see Grace, Donald, and Walter when God calls me home. We milked cows for 20 years as the children were growing up, and then they left home. And we decided to sell the cows and go cooking. in the boot camps, because I was already in Cross Haven. I cooked there for 20 years and cooked in Cross Haven for 1 week. You know, I went to Red Deer Lake and cooked there for just 1 week of the 16 years. And I was 20 years in on Red Deer at Cross Haven. And I enjoyed it all. We sold the farm and bought this house in town. We have been here since February of 1997. We liked it here. We could both drive, and we went places and visited family and friends. And then we both drove, but then one day Walter got sick and he says, I can't drive anymore. But we still went on because I could drive. I had to, then he got sick and didn't want to be alone, so I got home care to come and stay with him while I went shopping or going to church. I looked after him till the 11th of September, when he got worse, went to hospital, and passed away. On the 11th of September, 1999, when he passed away on the 11th of September, when his funeral was the 15th, as the at the Baptist Church right here, and the burial in the cemetery. I carried on. Cheryl has lived with me when she wasn't working out in the camps. And I did some writing, as Darlene Gordon had given me a little notebook to write in. Then I started writing. It had 325 pages, and I wrote all by hand. And Darlene then got that it published and as and it has professionally done. I've 100 out, and the second printing will be out soon. Then it seemed what comes next, and this then in my book.
Now there are some of those books we have here, Darlene. Where is she? They're out on
the
table.
There's one. I've got one right there.
There's one there. Darlene has some more. So if you are interested in them, yeah, there's a cost to them. Talk to Darlene afterwards. You'll want to try and get one of these for sure. So.
And I can thank God keeping me safe all these years. And I pray, asking, as I am here, and my last breath, then I can keep going with the help of all my Christian friends. And then, since I wrote this, my son Donald had passed away the beginning of July, and that he had been in the home at Stony Plain, and he then went to hospital in St. Albert, and there he passed away. And I said, because I wasn't able to go and see him all that time that COVID was on. And I say he died of a broken heart and loneliness. And that was at the funeral. We didn't have a funeral because Donald wasn't well enough, no. And so we had a little funeral at Mojo's, and then he was cremated, and the ashes buried on Walter's grave in the cemetery here.
Can I ask you, you're going to take all my time for preaching, which would be just fine, but would you, you've got this book that is full of poems. There's a couple of poems in there. We're going to be talking about prayer, but you have a poem on the nighttime prayer.
Yes, I have that right here.
Can you read that one for us?
My prayer shall, my voice shall hear in the morning. O Lord, direct my prayer unto thee, and I will look up to you. My wake-up prayer and time for personal devotions must never replace duty. It is preparation of early morning regarding expectation myself with one who is to be my partner for the day, for the coming day. Isn't it exciting when I set my alarm clock at night? It is with prayer. Lord, awake me in the morning to meet you through the day. Morning is the gate of the day and should be guarded with prayer. My eyesight. He who rushes from his bed to his business and waits not to work in prayer and adoration is as foolish as though he had not put on his clothes or washed his face, and as unwise as though he dashed into battle without armor or arms, but beat ours. They in the safety, flowing river of communion with God before the heat of the wilderness and the burden of the day brings. And then I've got a poem for the children. One day in mellow autumn, when grapes were ripe and sweet, I heard beneath my window the patter of small feet. And peeping through the window, saw a little boy that I knew come nimbly up the stairs where the kindness was. He did not know I saw him, and I did not make it so. Though the grapes were very picked, and the boy was none of mine. If the little fellow claims, then shall I grudge a bunch or two? I will watch him for a moment and see what he could do. I watched. The eager longing in his eyes was plain to see. So plain that though I saw him, he was not aware of me. If the little fellow breaks, shall I grudge a bunch or two? I will watch him for a moment, see what he can do. The eagerness in his eyes was plain to see. So plain that though I saw him, was not aware of me. I heard him presently, I heard him say, Mama doesn't see me, with a wistful little sigh. But God sees everybody, she told me so today. So I mustn't touch my death, I'll run away. She scrambled down the ladder, but faster than he ran, I hurried from my window and caught the little man. With willing haste I parted, right clustered from the stem, and filled to overflowing his little hands with milk. He napped and washed and wondered, but his mother's heart was glad at the story I had to tell her about the little lad. And I've often thought that older folks than he might take it to advantage that God can always see. And I hope that that has been an inspiration for some of you. Thank you.
Let's pray. And I just thank the Lord for this day for Mrs. Schultz. Lord, thank you for the way that you have worked in Mrs. Schultz and her family, for the many years that you have given to her. And Lord, we pray that you would continue to grant her health and strength, and that the testimony of her life, the story of how she has come to follow you, might be an inspiration and continue to influence people in this church and their family and the community. Lord, until you call her home, may you give her a voice to speak and ears that will listen to the words that she has to say. So we do thank you for her, Father. And pray that you would give her a blessed day on her birthday today. 99 years. Lord, thank you. What a blessing. In Jesus' name, amen.
I'm just sorry that my eyesight is going and I just couldn't see.
Well, you know, you really came alive when you started to recite, which, by the way, folks, If all of the information we have is on our computers or our phones, we're in a lot of trouble when we get to her age. So he needs to somehow get up here. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for being patient with me. I'm so sorry.
Give you guys another chance to stand up and sing, and it's an appropriate song. The song is "Lord, I Need You." You don't get to 99 on your own, and all of us are in the middle of real life. And this is a song about where we are in the middle of our life.
Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. Runs me, your grace is born, where grace is found, is where you are, where you are, Lord, I am free, holy death is Christ in me.
Holiness is Christ in me.
fly through some stuff here. I want to talk to you today about, and it's not just me going to talk to you, but how to pray at home. You'll need one of these. Everyone get one of these. Grab one of these. So get some of you at the back there to hand some out. Tiny will bring you a bunch. And my daughter Brooklyn there. This is a booklet, and you'll see on the very front, there's four different times to pray, and we're going to go through a few of these in a minute. But I want to just kind of inspire you. The scripture says in 1 Thessalonians 5, 16-18, it says, be joyful, not sometimes, but always. Pray continually. And give thanks in all circumstances. You hear that? It's talking about pray, be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances. And so I want to, this morning, just walk you through and try and inspire. You heard from Mrs. Schultz about how important it is to spend some time in the morning with the Lord in prayer, and it'd be like getting up and not even getting dressed is getting up and not talking to the Lord and how important it is. But the question is, how do we do these sorts of things? So I'm going to walk you through some very tangible things in a minute, but I'm going to get Miss Helen to come here. She shared with the children a very simple way of praying and how to remember how to pray. And us adults are never too old to learn some of these things. These are important things. So I'm going to get Miss Helen to come and share with us what she shared with the kids about how to pray.
He draws even closer. He wants us. He knows that certain things that we do will harm us in the long run. And he loves us so much that he doesn't want us to go through such difficulties and the consequences of our choices. Sometimes we don't know the consequences at the end. Thanking God for Jesus, for sending Jesus to pay the penalty for our sins. And we're thanking him for our families, thanking him for our nice soft beds and food on our table. And I showed a picture to the kids of, and I just lost his name. He has no arms and legs. Pardon? Yeah, I can't think of his name.
Nick.
Yes. I showed pictures and how thankful we are that we can walk and that we have hands that we can pick things, that we have arms that we can hug people that we love. And also I showed pictures to the kids. Oh, and this man, he loves the Lord. He goes all over the world talking about the love of Jesus. And he has no arms and no legs. Do we have it hard? No, but this man loves Jesus with all his heart, and he's a prayer warrior. He prays and thanks God for everything that God has given him. I also showed pictures to the kids of kids in third world countries where they go to school with books over their backs like this, and their school is outside. It's not in a nice class. It's not in a nice, comfy place. So we are to thank God for all that he has given to us and to pray for others. There are so many needs around us, those in our own families, there's needs there. I have all the scripture written down. I have this book here again. Of course, I'm not opening it. To pray for the needs of others. Help us to have eyes to see other people, to see if they're struggling with anything. Asking God to show us who to pray for, how to pray for them. And to pray for ourselves, because we need prayer as well. We may be struggling with things. Maybe school, maybe learning, maybe struggling with siblings. Maybe I told the kids about my brother and I, but I'm not going to tell that story again. They've heard it so many times. He punched me out, but anyway. Took my breath away, and he got into trouble. Now I pray for him. And then, of course, closing in prayer. Thank you, God. So this is just it's not, as I said, it's not in cement. But I have to tell you when we first started. Now, some of you kids, like the two Dombrowski kids over there, they were the only ones here in the Sunday school class. And I brought this phone. Now, if you remember the old days, we used to be able to turn it up. Well, this is anyway. So there was only the two, and I don't know if I did it with you girls as well. Maybe you weren't there because sometimes the kids aren't there altogether. So I'm sitting and I'm talking to the kids. Oh yes, there was another class. I don't think you were there. I go, oh, just a minute. Hello? Hi, God. Yeah? Yes, we're in church. Of course you know we're in church. Mm-hmm. Yes, she's here. Yep, she's here too. I know. What do you want me to tell them? That you see them? You love them. He loves you. Very, very much. Oh, sorry. Very, 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 very much. Just as you are. Just as you are. Okay, you're not tough. Okay. Thank you. Okay, bye. And I get the phone now. Ida says, it's not connected. I don't know if you remember that, honey. I remember. So another time, hello, yes, we're still here. Yes, I know you love to see us singing and worshiping you. You love dancing too, can you too? Okay, I'll tell them. Guess what? Mrs. Campbell.
God loves me. God loves me.
Yes. He loves you very, 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 very much. Okay. Okay, thank you, God. Love you too. Bye. Oh, pardon? Oh, you want to talk to them? Oh. Well, how are they going to do that? Your special book, the Bible. Yes, of course. Okay. Bye-bye. Prayer is not just us this way, this way. It's a relationship. I said to the kids, you know, what if you got up in the morning and nobody spoke? Or you got up and you're sitting there and your mom had breakfast or cereal or something out there, but she never said a word to you. Or you didn't give her the time because you were so busy with whatever you're doing. God wants to talk to us. I have to say one more thing with this, and my heart just rejoiced. I had a mom talk to me after this, one of these phone things, and she said, Mom, you gotta talk to Miss Helen. I want you to phone Miss Helen and get God's phone number, because I gotta talk to him. And that was the introduction to prayer. That's where that was going. So, yes, yeah, so I'm not gonna go into all my little notes here. This here came to my heart this morning, and it's from Zephaniah 3:17. The Lord, your God, is in the midst of me. He is mighty, and he will save, and he will rejoice over you with joy. He will rest in his love. He will joy over you with singing. And I'm going to read the Living Bible version. For the Lord your God has arrived to live among you. He is a mighty Savior, and he will give you victory. Whatever you're struggling with, he will give you the victory. Trust him. He will rejoice over you in great gladness, and he will love you and not accuse you. Is that a joyous choir I hear? No, it is the Lord himself exalting over you in happy song. Can you imagine God singing a song over you? So that's kind of where we've been going. We are doing a prayer wall. We're just starting it all coming together. It's going to be like a prayer tower that we're going to be doing, where it will be kids' requests, you know, prayer requests, also the church families through the prayer chain. And that's kind of in a nutshell what the kids are going to be doing. Lord, I need thee. This really popped out for me this morning, not that I haven't sung it before. Lord, I come and I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. And without you, I fall apart. You're the one who guides my heart. Our lives will fall apart without him leading us. Without him leading us. And we can come to the Lord as we are, and that is turning. And so I see all my notes that I didn't open. So Lord, I thank you. I thank you for this family, this church family. I thank you for the children here. I pray, Lord, that by your Holy Spirit, you will speak to each and touch every heart here, that we can know, Lord, that we can come to you just as we are. We don't have to jump hoops or perform. And Lord, I pray for anyone here who has been wounded by other Christians. Lord, I pray that you reach deep, deep, deep into their hearts and reveal to them that your love is great for them. Your love is so deep and wide and great for them. Draw them to yourself, Lord. I pray by your Holy Spirit, draw them back to yourself. This is not a religion, Lord. It is a living relationship with you, the one true God,
one true God. Lord, you demonstrated your love for us while we were in the midst of our sin. You went on the cross and took our place, and you rose again the third day to give us life. Give us a new life, Lord. That is amazing to even think of it, a different life. And God, you are true to your word. The work that you have begun in our lives, Lord, you will complete it until the day of Christ. And I thank you, Lord Jesus, for that. Bless these people and the children here, I pray in your name. Amen. One more thing. Sorry. I need... Where did I put it? Okay. I need moms and dads, and... Sorry, it's just a little thing that I have that the kids would like. Okay. So I need the kids here. Okay. Adults have to do this too, okay? It's a little rhyme, and it's hand motions, and you have to repeat it. You can come up if you want to. Sure, you can come up and do this. You're going to have to see what I'm doing, though. It's up to you. She's not sure. Oh, it's okay, honey. Okay, so everybody, can you... Okay. So do this together, okay? Yeah, I might as well stand up. Okay. Everybody, they do these actions, okay? And you have to repeat after me. God is always ready to hear.
God is always ready to hear.
Words we speak that are sincere.
Words we speak that are sincere.
He will listen to every prayer.
He will listen to every prayer.
Anytime and anywhere.
Anytime and anywhere.
God pays attention to every word.
God pays attention to every word.
Nothing we say will go unheard.
Nothing we say will go unheard.
So talk to God. Both night and day. And close beside him, you will stay.
Close beside him, you will stay.
Right. And by the way, it's a local call.
And it's never busy.
And it's never busy.
Never busy.
I was thinking how powerful that would be if God was on the end of the line and Miss Helen handed you the phone and said, God wants to talk to you. What would you say? Wrong number. I'm busy. Yeah. Okay, so over these next couple of weeks, we're going to be looking at some very practical kind of things that we want to encourage you to do. Now, if you were here a few weeks ago, I shared what's happening in our country. If we don't share about God in our own homes and teach our kids and our grandkids what it means to do some simple things like talking to God in prayer and reading our Bible at home. It's not about just showing up in church on Sunday morning. It matters much more what's happening at home for you, and you all have homes that you live in. So there are... anytime prayers, and there's lots of different ways of doing it. Miss Helen showed us the five finger things. Let me see if I can remember. The first one is thank God, confess your sins, praise God, confess your sins, thank God, pray for others, and the pinky, the smallest one, pray for yourself. And then it's kind of like you wrap it all up. Right in the middle, number six is amen. Okay? So that's the sort of thing that you can pray anytime. And you should have some time during the day when you can use that if you like to get just start going on some of these things. How do you pray? Just think, okay, what do I say to God? Because prayer is a conversation with God. And like Ms. Helen said, we hear from God by His Holy Spirit and by His Word. And we need to get into the Bible so that we know what God wants to say to us. But those are, we should take some time out during the day and spend a special time, take 5 minutes out, take 3 minutes out, and maybe just go through this and praise God and confess your sins and thank God and pray for others and pray for myself. Amen. Take some time to do that. But there are some special times during the day, especially if you've got kids at home and that sort of thing, that I want to just spend the rest of this time just walking through quickly and very tangible. So one of those times is our meal times. And you can see on the front of these books, there's mealtime there. And there's a verse that says, when Jesus was at the table with them, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and began to give it to others. Now, the way this book is broken up, and this, by the way, is an app that I'm in the middle of developing. So I think it, in some of these, refers to an app. So you'll have to ignore that. But basically, the first bit of this are all different mealtime prayers that you can do. Then it's wake time prayers, so when you get up in the morning. Then drive time prayers. This is assuming that you have passengers in your vehicle, so you should be reading this while you're driving. And then the end is nighttime prayers. So we're going to start with this, and I'm going to get, everyone gets a choice of, and you're not allowed to start eating this yet, because you have to actually do a prayer. You get a choice of a dad's cookie, or some fruit sensations, or... and we'll need some kids to help pass these out, or chips. So everyone, let's just kind of go through and make a choice of what you want, dads or some fruit sensations or chips. Everyone needs something. Okay, and as they're passing them out, let me ask you, how did you pray, or do you pray around meal times in your family? Some example of how you do that. How do you pray? Bless this, what? Bless this bunch as we munch and crunch this lunch. Okay. How else do you pray? Do you, does dad pray? Who prays? You take turns praying? Okay. How else do you guys pray in your homes? Take turns? You sing Johnny Appleseed. Well, let's hear it. How does Johnny Appleseed go? I'll sing it with you. Well, I might have a slightly different version. Oh, the Lord is good to me, and so I thank the Lord for giving me the things I need, the sun and the rain and the apple seed. The Lord is good to me, Johnny Appleseed. Amen. Okay, there's a different version of that. How else do you pray at home, at around mealtime? Pick one of the kids. All right, we're not going to make you pray. Okay, how do you pray?
Thank you for the spoon and the hands that you bear. Please bless them. Please bless the food to our body. And please bless the people of this land. Amen.
Amen. Okay. Don't start eating yet. I should have told you that. Don't start eating yet. We have a break. Okay, anyone else that wants to tell us how you pray? You're one of those. Okay, in your books, in the very front, there's a whole bunch of prayers. Before you eat, someone in your group, and you have to be with, so if you'll have to join in with someone else. If you've got a family, that works perfectly. Otherwise, you have to have a couple of people. You have to pick a prayer, and then before you eat, you have to say your prayer. So we're practicing this, because a lot of times you haven't prayed in your home. Praying the first time is probably the most difficult time. So I'm going to say go in a minute, and then you can do your prayer with someone else, and then you can eat. All right. Have you got your prayer picked out? All right. Now, practice your prayer. Go.
Thank you.
All right.
Now, you can just keep munching. We're going to pretend that these are bedtime snacks, too, while you continue eating. And a minute here, we're going to turn off the lights. And you have to do a bedtime prayer, a nighttime prayer. Now, there are some here. How do some of you pray at nighttime? What are some of the things that you do before you go to bed if you pray? How do you older people, how do you pray before bed? What do you do?
Have my devotions.
You have your devotions? Okay. So you're listening to what God is saying to you. So you're reading something? Okay.
Thank you for keeping your hand upon me through another day.
All right. Thank you for keeping your hand. We need to be praying that, eh? Yeah. Thankful for the bed that we have to sleep on. There's so many are without that. We hear on the news about people who are living in their home. Yeah, we need to be thankful for that. Anything else? How did you pray, some of you older people? Oh, yeah.
I thank the Lord for the day and trusting you through the night.
Pray for others that don't know him. Thank you. Yeah, Jeremy.
I thank him for the victories, and I give them back to him. And I thank him for the sorrows, and I give them in trust. And I invite him to live my dream life and to have adventures with him. Adventures with Jesus.
How did you, some of you older people, how did you pray with your kids when they were young? Did you pray in bed with them? Did you pray kicking in bed? How did you do some of those things? Yeah. It's difficult. Now, if you haven't done some of these things at home, I really want to encourage you to do this, especially if you've got kids. Don't let the time slip by. But it will freak them out if you start doing it right now. Like, if they're teenagers and you're like, and I didn't do this near as much as I should have with my kids when they were younger. I really regret not doing that. I wish that someone would have said, hey, by the way, don't forget, pray with the kids. Because time goes by and you're like, oh, I should be praying with them. When my son was older, especially when he was 17 and stuff, I would pray with, I'd put my arms around him and he'd start to fill out and pat him on the back and you'd hear kind of his chest fill out, and then I would just kind of pray with him a little bit before I went off to bed. Try to pray with the kids as they were growing up. So we're going to turn the lights out, so pick a prayer. We're going to pretend that it's nighttime. When I say go, I'm going to turn this light out, and that'll be go. And then you just take a minute and pretend it's nighttime and say a prayer. Now, there are prayers in here. You can just repeat one of these out, but someone needs to be the one that does the prayer, okay? So find the prayer you want to do. The lights are going to go out, and that's your time to pray. You've got young children that are already probably screaming. There's some wait time prayers that you can use so someone can start to have a look at those. There's lots of ways of doing wait time prayers. You can crawl beside your bed in the morning and just, I've actually found in the last while, it's the easiest way to get out of bed. Just kind of roll over and then you just kind of get in a kneeling position. I didn't know this until like probably about 3 months ago. And I just roll out of bed, and the side of bed, and then I just take a minute and I pray there. And I pray, God, help me today. Keep me free from sin. Guide me during the day. You can use it. That's a really good time to use the Lord's Prayer. So in a minute, the lights are going to come back on, and it's going to be morning time. So someone pick a morning prayer, and we'll just do that prayer as we start the day, okay? So find a prayer. Are you ready? The lights will come on in a minute. Can I encourage you to take some of these home? You can take one of these, and each of you have a home. And there are some key times during the day. When you start the day, turn to God and say a prayer. When you sit down and eat, especially if you're eating with other people, I would encourage you, even if you're by yourself, just take a minute and say, God, thank you for this food. In my family growing up, my dad was, God, thank you for this food and bless it for our body's use in Jesus' name, amen. And he would just point to one of us boys and say, you say a prayer. And over time, maybe I've shared this before, it got abbreviated. We knew what he was going to say. So to this day, if we go there and dad prays, it'll be God, thank you for this food in Jesus' name, amen. And that's the prayer. We don't know what he's saying, but we stop and we take a minute before we get on with eating our food. Before we start into our stuff, learning to talk to God. And then at the end of the day, taking some time. And if we can, during the day, to spend some time to pray continually. Can I ask one further thing? If you are a senior or if you have grandchildren, let this be something you model in your home. Because your kids are really in a lot of hurt. They got lots going on. And it's hard for them to have, you know, that sort of routine in their lifestyle. If they come over to Grandpa and Grandma's place, let them see that in your life. That will have an incredible impact. And if you don't have kids and you have a spouse, or if you are just by yourself, let this be something that's part of your lifestyle. And if people get the opportunity to come and visit you, or you go and you go home, or you're going to visit someone else, take that pattern with you. Learn to talk with God as you go through your life. So we're gonna wrap it up with that. We're gonna have a song, closing song here, and then invite you to come down. It's downstairs, right? Thank you, Pat and Percy, for giving us all arranged for some birthday cake. All right, so that'll be downstairs after we sing this song.
Yeah, before we sing happy birthday, we've got to remember who's walked beside Mrs. Schultz for 99 years, who was there when she was born, and who's waiting for her to welcome her home when her time is done. And all of us, we're looking forward to being told welcome and be called a good and faithful servant. Let's stand together and sing, I surrender all.
Oh, to Jesus I surrender all, to Him I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him, in His presence daily live.
Come out this way. We want to sing happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
You can feel free to get closer to her if any of you want to. Let's sing happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mrs. Schultz. Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.